First rib, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. So, так, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Superior border of the heart is at the level of third ribs. Left border, sorry, right border of the heart from third rib
fifth
till fifth rib, 1-2 centimeters laterally from the border of the sternum. Apex of the heart. It is linea medio clavicularis. In fifth left intercostal space, 1.5 centimeters medially, 1.5 centimeter medially from linea media clavicularis, that is apex. Inferior border from fifth rib to apex, and left border from third rib to apex. That is borders of the heart. Clear?
Yes.
From which points? Vertically from third rib vertically to the level of 1.5 centimeters medially from. Next, projection of valves. Valva aorta is behind of sternum at the level of third rib, and valva of pulmonary trunk is in place where third rib attached to the sternum here. Next, we draw oblique line from third rib on the left till fifth rib on the right. And mitral valve is above of this oblique line, and tricuspid valve is below. Clear? And now points of auscultation. Valva aorta in second right intercostal space near the sternum. Valva of pulmonary trunk, second left intercostal space near the sternum. Mitral valve, valva bicuspidalis on the apex, and tricuspid valve in place where fifth right rib attached to the sternum. That is topography of heart. And now, auscultation, that is, if we need to listen heartbeat. I think you know that fundoscope, that is apparate, yes, which attached to thoracic cage, and listen heartbeat. What we listen? We listen to tone. I think that everybody knows that heartbeat is something. Two tones. First tone, that is bicuspid and tricuspid valve closed. Second tone, that is valva aorta and valve of pulmonary trunk closed. And that is why if we put fundoscope in, for example, on the neck, here it is, we also will listen two tones. If you put on the abdomen, we also can see, can listen two tones of the heart. On the back, we also will listen two tones. But why we need to put fundoscope in these points? Because, for example, we listen noise in first tone, not this way, tuk tuk, but shtuk, shtuk. In first tone, we listen noise. It may be problem with bicuspid or tricuspid valve. We put fundoscope on the apex, and we can listen this noise very clear. And then put on the fifth rib, and not so clear, listen this noise. Here, very clear, here it is not so. That is why problem with mitral bicuspid valve. The same noise in second tone. Tuksh, tuksh, tuksh. that is problem in aorta or in pulmonary trunk. Put fundoscope here, very clear. Here it is not so clear. That is why problem with valva aorta. That is why it is necessary to know points of auscultation to decide in which valve we have problem. That is topography of heart. Now arteries of the heart and veins. Two arteries we know in heart, supply heart. First of all, beginning of aorta has name bulb of aorta, bulbus aorta, here it is, this place. And from bulb of aorta start two arteries. Here it is left coronary artery, and here it is right coronary artery. Left coronary artery very short, only 2 centimeters, and then it's divided into two main branches. Here it is ramus circumflexus and ramus interventricularis anterior. Right coronary artery start from bulb, surround right border of the heart, go into coronary sinus, and here it is on posterior surface, on diaphragmatic surface, it is absent. It give branch from here, branch go downward, and name of this branch ramus interventricularis posterior. And these two branches, ramus interventricularis posterior and ramus interventricularis anterior, they make anastomosis on the apex of heart. And arteria coronaria dextra, it also make anastomosis with ramus circumflexus. That is why we have two rings. Why? Well, first arterial ring in horizontal plane, and this ring formed with the help of right coronary artery, left coronary artery, and ramus circumflexus. And another ring in vertical plane with the help of anterior interventricular branch and posterior interventricular branch. Two rings in the region of heart. And then necessary to prepare which artery supply which departments of heart. For example, right coronary artery supply right atrium, part of anterior wall of right ventricle, all posterior wall of right ventricle, posterior wall of left ventricle, posterior third of septum interventriculare, all papillary muscles in right ventricle and posterior papillary muscle in left ventricle. Another departments of heart receive blood from left coronary artery. What is here? The same left coronary artery, ramus circumflexus, ramus interventricularis anterior. Here it is right coronary artery, and here it is ramus interventricularis posterior. What is here? Left coronary artery. It is ramus, it is heart is deforme. Left coronary artery, from here start ramus interventricularis anterior, it is ramus circumflexus, and it is part of right coronary artery and ramus interventricularis posterior. We can see also it is here. That is beginning of left coronary artery. Here it is, beginning of left coronary artery. And this artery start in place where valva, here it is, valvula semilunaris, is present. And in time of systole, when heart contract, valvula semilunaris attached to wall of aorta and closed beginning of coronary arteries, clear? That is why blood supply of heart we have only in time of diastole, in time when valve closed, and in this case blood go into the coronary artery. In time of systole of the heart, valvula similaris closed, opening of coronary arteries. And some words about veins of the heart. About veins of the heart. I think you know that main vein of the heart, it is coronary sinus, sinus coronarius cordis. It opens into right
atrium.
Another veins, in heart we have three venous system. Main venous system of the heart, that is coronary sinus. Another are anterior veins of the heart and smallest veins of the heart. Vena cordis anterioris and vena cordis minima, smallest. These veins, anterior and smallest, insert into right atrium or into right ventricle yourself. Small openings of veins in ventricle and in atrium. Clear it is? And coronary sinus, that is main venous system of the heart, and this coronary sinus receive five main veins. What happened?
Please disturb me.
Please put your medical room. What happened?
What is venous blood?
Not oxygenated blood. Heart receive oxygenated blood through coronary arteries, and venous or not oxygenated blood go into right ventricle, and from right end ventricle go to lungs. And now, which veins take place in coronary sinus? First vein, vena cordis magna. This vein is situated in sulcus interventricularis anterior, surround left border of the heart, and continue into coronary sinus. Vena cordis magna. Next vein, vena cordis parva. Vena cordis parva is between right atrium and right ventricle. It go medially and insert also into coronary sinus. Next vein, vena cordis media. This vein is in sulcus interventricularis posterior and go into coronary sinus. One again. Vena cordis magna, vena cordis parva, vena cordis media. And last two veins are vena posterior of the left ventricle, vena posterior ventriculi sinistri, and oblique vein of left atrium, vena obliqua atrii sinistri. Vena posterior ventriculi sinistri of the left ventricle, and vena obliqua atrii sinistri, oblique vein of left atrium. Five veins form coronary sinus, and coronary sinus inflow into right atrium. And last moment, that is pericardium. Today you already know that pericardium has two layers, external pericardium fibrosum and internal pericardium serosum. And serous layer has parietal and visceral. Visceral layer has name epicardium. And in pericardium we know two sinuses. First sinus is behind of aorta and pulmonary trunk. It is transverse sinus, sinus transversus pericardii. And another sinus is oblique, sinus obliquus pericardii. It is difficult to see because it is absent pericardium. Next week we put here body corp. And on the corp we will see these two sinuses. Today only necessary to know two sinuses, transverse and oblique. That is all.
Next week mini exam.
Next week mini exam on Monday, yes? On Monday mini exam. We start diagrams and then answer on preparation. Today at 5 o'clock. Okay. I will duty on tutorials. Okay, welcome.
Tutorial for this.
No, tutorial if you want to. Yes, if you want mini.